You know what? I have come to a realization. I have been treating Mario poorly, forcing him to dodge all of the shiny yellow coins during his adventures. I feel like my boy Mario needs a vacation, and today, I'll actually be nice with him. So I got him, Peach, and Grandpa Toad a ticket to Delfino Plaza, the best vacation island resort in the whole Mushroom Kingdom. Psych! This is yet another challenge video, my dude! Gotcha! In other words, today we'll attempt to beat Super Mario Sunshine without touching a single coin. The rules are simple. We are going to try to beat Super Mario Sunshine for the Nintendo GameCube without touching any of those yucky yellow coins. You see this lovely coin counter at the top over there? Well, we need to keep it at zero for the entire game. Super Mario Sunshine also has another coin counter that's always showing up over there, the blue coins. These can be exchanged for shine sprites in a normal playthrough, but since those coins can show up over there, I'm going to avoid touching the blue coins as well. To beat Super Mario Sunshine, you need to complete Episode 7 of every single world. So unlike Super Mario 64, we won't be able to skip any level that are too difficult. This will definitely be interesting and make the challenge more difficult. So without further ado, let's just jump into it. So while Mario was having dreams of actually collecting coins, the plane had to make an abrupt stop because of all the weird paint on the landing strip. Just move your way across this area and grab this little robot called Flood. With Flood equipped, you can now spray water and clean up the entire island. The game even gives you some paint to spray as a tutorial. And, well, watch out for the coins that appear after you clean that paint. That Pianta dude over there doesn't believe his eyes. I know, dude, coins in the tutorial? That's plain evil. Spray this thing, kill the plant, and you'll get your very first shine sprite. Sadly, you'll also get arrested by the police for no reason, and will be forced to clean the entire island because these dudes think that is you. Although it absolutely looks nothing like you. Oh well. Time to make our way to Bianco Hills, the first level of the game, and start collecting some shine sprites. Bianco 1 wants you to take this path to get to your destination, and there are lots of coins on the way, so you're going to have to move around the evil coins. But thankfully, there's a lot of grass to stand on, and reaching the paint plant without touching a single coin is pretty simple. Bianco 2 wants you to go back to the exact same path, except this time around, most of the coins that were in the way have been removed, making this one even easier. Get on top of the windmill and you'll get to fight Petey Piranha. Thankfully for us, there is not a single coin in the battle arena, so this level will be done in no time. Bianco 3 will ask you to get to a secret cave, and once again, there are no coins on the way to the cave, so entering it will be a cakewalk. Welcome to your first secret challenge, levels taking place in an alternate universe where you cannot actually use Flood, and are forced to do some classic Mario platforming. Looks like I'm not really good because I kept dying over and over again, but I can assure you that coins have nothing to do with it, as there's none of them in the cave. Bianco 4 is up, and it's named Red Coins of the Windmill Village. Ugh. Now this scared me a lot, because in Super Mario 64, red coins used to increase your total coin counter, forcing us to skip those levels when we did the Without a Coin challenge. And sadly, as I mentioned, you cannot really skip episodes in Mario Sunshine, because you need to beat the first 7 ones in every single level to beat it. So I went ahead slowly, and did touch the red coin, and oh my gosh, it has its own temporary coin counter down there, meaning it will not actually increase the total yellow or blue coin counter. Oof, we are saved. The quest can continue. Yes. Collect all of the red coins and you'll beat this level quite easily. Bianco 5 is a rematch against Petey Piranha, but you'll be fighting it in the village this time around. Be careful when spraying the paint on the floor, as there are evil coins hidden in it and they pop out after you wash the paint down. Always spray from afar to be safe. Bianco 6 is another level featuring a secret cave where you cannot use Flood to help you out. Just like the previous secret cave level, there is not a single coin in it, so just make your way to the end and you'll be good to go. we have now reached episode 7 of Bianco Hills. And episode 7s in Super Mario Sunshine are always about you chasing down Shadow Mario, having to spray water on him until he collapses and gives you the Shine Sprite. This is pretty easy, and there are no evil coins on the way. With Shadow Mario gone and the Shine Sprite ours, Bianco Hills is now complete! Let's kill another one of those gooey plants and explore the next world, Rico Harbor. The first episode features lots of coins on the way to the blooper dude we need to defeat. Plus, you're often hanging on ceilings or fences, so avoiding those coins becomes quite confusing, but it is possible. Once we reach Bloopy the Blooper, we'll have to avoid the coins located around it while we fight. It's not gonna be a tough fight though. Rico 2 wants you to hop on one of those bloopers and follow the coins to the secret cave. Obviously, we'll have to maneuver around the coins, but it is possible to enter the cave anyways. Once you're inside of it, there are no more coins standing in between you and the Shine Sprite, so just have some fun with the blooper. Rico 3 does contain a few coins here and there as you make your way inside the big yellow cage, but they're all pretty easy to dodge. Speaking of easy things, Rico 4 doesn't have a single coin leading to the goal, and once you're inside of the secret level without Flood on your back, well, there's no coins either, so this one's a freebie. Rico 5 is a simple rematch against the blooper, except this time around, there are no coins on your way. Yeah, it's easier. Anyways, we had our share of easy Shine Sprites, but get ready, because Rico 6 is not going to be that nice to us. In this one, we have a time limit of 2 minutes to collect 8 red coins located on the water. To do so, we have to hop on one of those super fast moving bloopers from before. The problem is that most of those lovely red coins are surrounded by evil yellow coins, so if we end up collecting one of those by accident, we're toasted. Oh, and if we bump into anything, I mean even the slightest little tiny baby bump, we automatically lose a life. That Shine Sprite was quite difficult to obtain and took me many tries, but eventually I managed to get all of the red coins and dodge all of those pesky yellow ones. Time for Rico 7, and chasing Shadow Mario is quite easy and will be done without a coin. With Rico Harbor complete, we can now make our way over there and open up Gelato Beach. Gelato. Tasty. Gelato 1 starts off with a very easy stage where you just spray water on this sprout over there to reach a secret area. Thankfully, there are no coins on the beach and no coins in the secret area, so we're good to go. Gelato 2 wants you to spray those dudes with water and then do a ground pound to fly them out of here. There's absolutely no coins on the mirrors where you fight those dudes, but be extra careful, because you get teleported once you clear a mirror of enemies, and one of those mirrors actually teleports you over there once the cutscene is over. And as you can see, that's quite a lot of coins around us. Carefully move out of there and you'll be good. Gelato 3 is a boss battle against a big, angry green Wiggler, but there's no coins on the way, so you're good to go. Gelato 4 is home to the infamous Sand Bird. Ugh. Everybody that played Super Mario Sunshine once in their lives has bad memories of this stage. You have to collect 8 red coins to get the Shine Sprite to appear, and you have to find a way to stay on the bird without falling down. And well, now we also have to dodge those evil yellow coins as well. This level was a real challenge, and I actually fell down a lot, especially when trying to get the red coin on the sand bird's tail. I mean, look at that, avoiding all of those yellow coins and only touching the red coin to then going back on the sand bird was quite the task. Thankfully, it is difficult but possible to do it. Just prepare to die a lot though. Gelato 5 introduces Il Piantissimo, who acts as this game's Koopa the Quick. Basically, just make a run to the flagpole and win the race for an easy Shine Sprite. There are no coins on the way too, so we're good. Gelato 6 wants you to collect a bunch of red coins in those reefs over there, and thankfully, you'll only find red coins, so for this quest, it is pretty easy. Guess what? We're now at Gelato Beach 7, and all we need to do is to catch Shadow Mario for an easy shine, and on that note, Gelato Beach is a thing of the past. It's finally time for us to go to that weird-looking submarine boat thingy and explore Peanut Park. As we make our way inside of the theme park, we finally get a good look at Shadow Mario, and it turns out it's actually just Bowser Jr. Oh my gosh, what a shock! He says he captured Princess Peach because she's her mama. This is pretty weird, but let's not let that distract us from the fact that we need to defeat this big evil robot using rockets while riding a roller coaster. Thankfully, there's zero coins in this one. Peanut 2 forces you to use those bombs to attack this bunker and force the Monty Mole out of it. Watch out while throwing the bombs as they sometimes miss the target and explode into deadly coins that come back right at you. Once you defeat the mole, explore the secret area and you'll get the Shine Sprite. Peanut 3 wants you to collect 8 red coins located in the many attractions of this park. This is especially scary when the red coins are surrounded by evil yellow coins like over there. Ugh, just be extra careful, and with a bit of practice, skill, and luck, you'll clear this one without a coin. Peanut 4 is home to those Yoshi egg looking turtles. The plan is to ground pound all of them to save the sunflower and get the Shine Sprite. If there's one tip I can give you out for this one, it would be to quickly move away from the turtle after doing your ground pound, because during a cutscene, tons of evil coins appear, and if you're not far enough from the turtle, you'll definitely end up collecting a few. Peanut 5 is a pretty annoying level, not because of coins, but mostly because of horrible camera controls. I mean, how am I supposed to climb up the tower with such a bad camera? Oh, and can we talk about this? What the heck just happened? Are you okay, Mario? Are you okay, my dude? Peanut 6 is really easy. Just get my boy Yoshi some fruits and explore the secret cave, which, just like all of the other ones in the quest, doesn't feature a single coin. Let's chase Shadow Mario down and defeat him to get the final Shine Sprite and clear Peanut Park forever. Next up is Noki Bay, and this level is going to be pretty annoying, not gonna lie. Noki 1 forces you to make your way up this mountain that's covered in evil paint, and as you make your way up and spray the paint away, evil coins will appear, so you'll have to be very careful. After making your way to the top, you'll need to grab some bombs and throw them at this bunker and... As I was saying, just throw 3 bombs, don't fall down, and defeat the dude to recover the Shine Sprite. In Noki 2, you're normally meant to use Flood on those tiles on the wall to uncover secret tunnels and areas to make your way to the top of the world. Now, obviously this won't be possible, because these tunnels are full of evil yellow coins and there's literally no way to dodge those. Thankfully, Flood will be of great help, as we can just start climbing on those platforms and make our way as high as possible while dodging the pesky yellow coins on the way, and we'll soon reach the top of the world and we'll fight Bloopy the Blooper. Yup, he's back again. Don't you ever give up, bruh. Once that is done, the shine is ours. In Noki 3, Mario gets shrunk and gets teleported inside of a bottle to recover red coins. Pretty random if you ask me. Anyways, 7 of those red coins are actually quite easy to get, but the final one will be quite a pain in the butt. You see, this final red coin is over there, and when you're trying to grab it, there's an invisible water spray thingy that keeps pushing you up. Normally, I suppose you're meant to grab all of those yellow coins from the bottom and make your way up there to grab the red one afterwards, but we can't do that this time around because yellow coins are yucky. It took me a couple of tries to get the angle just right, but it is actually possible to just grab the red coin while avoiding all of those other yellow ones. It is not really fun and pretty confusing, but it is possible nonetheless. Noki 4 scared me a lot because you're meant to fight this evil fish boss dude that sprays toxic bubbles at you and tries to swallow you whole. To defeat the dude, you have to clean his teeth. Yep, that's right, you clean his teeth to defeat him, and people still argue that Super Mario Sunshine isn't an educational game. Pff, cringe. The problem is that you normally recover air by touching yellow coins, and we cannot actually do that. I was afraid this level was the end of the quest, up until I sprayed one of those toxic bubbles and realized it explodes into air bubbles that we can breathe to replenish our health. Now this is pretty cool, and with that neat trick, defeating the fish and getting the shine is a piece of delicious cake. Noki 5 is yet another race with Il Piantissimo, and there are 0 coins on the way, so this one is easy. The same thing can be said about Noki 6, where you just make your way up those platforms to the secret area and there are no coins on your path. Finally, chase down Shadow Mario once again to get his shine sprite and clear Noki Bay for good. Serena Beach is our next stop, and the very first episode is quite the challenge. There's electric paint everywhere, and we have to clean it up using Flood. Here's the problem though, there's tons of evil coins hiding in the paint, so you'll have to be very careful while cleaning up the beach. I suggest cleaning up as much as you can before talking to this dude and summoning the Manta Bus, because spraying all of those little Manta rays while avoiding coins can be quite a challenge. Just be careful, take your time, and you'll be good. Serena 2 is super easy, as you literally just have to enter the hotel and then to spray water on those pink boos to create a staircase and get to the secret cave. And thankfully, there are no coins anywhere on your way. Serena 3 is a really annoying level, because it's actually quite unclear what we need to do. We have to explore the secret parts of the hotel by discovering hidden areas, but I mean, that's kind of random. Once you figure out what to do though, this level is not that difficult. Once you manage to get Yoshi and go back up in the vents, make sure to eat those ghosts and move away before you touch the evil coins that they give out when defeated. Beside that little inconvenience, this level is not that difficult. Serena 4 takes place in the hotel's casino, and if there's anything I know about casinos, is that there might be coins involved. Watch out when spinning those slot machines, as they tend to give out evil coins. Spin some lucky sevens, and then you'll beat this stage easily. Serena 5 is up, and it's a simple fight against King Boo in the casino's basement. Thankfully, there is not a single coin on the way, or not a single coin during the fight, so this one is quite easy. Serena 6 forces you to clean up the island once again, but you have a limited amount of time to do so. Thankfully, all of the evil coins that were hidden in the paint in episode 1 are now gone, so this level will be done in no time. Serena 7 forces you to chase down Shadow Mario in the hotel, and this will be quite easy to do. Goodbye, Serena Beach! Next up is Pianta Village, and the very first shine sprite we'll get will be easily obtained. Basically, all we need to do is to grab the chain chumps and throw them in the pool to cool them off. To be honest, I always was a cat person, so these chain chumps are not my best friends. Pianta 2 is another race with Il Piantissimo, and just like all of those levels, there are no coins on the way, so this will be done easily. Pianta 3 is such an interesting level. You don't have flood in this one, and the village is actually covered with lava paint, so you'll need to go underneath the stage on those fences to then reach this area. Once you're there, make a very precise jump on that mushroom, and then do an epic YOLO jump over there to recover flood. Once that is done, well, basically you can just spray water everywhere, so just spray this dude to save him and the shine will be yours. Pianta 4 is up, and you need to give another chain chump a good old bath. Once again, there's not gonna be any coins on the way, so this one is easy. Pianta 5 wants you to get Yoshi and to explore the underside of the village. Getting Yoshi is pretty easy, but I do admit that jumping on those mushroom platforms is a little bit scary. There are tons of coins on them, so you'll have to be very careful where you walk. Thankfully, you'll soon reach this platform, spray the lava wall, and enter the secret area. We're not done yet though, because this secret area is a pain in the butt. You have to talk to these, I'm a Chuckster, guys that will throw you to other platforms. If that isn't difficult enough, there's now also coins that you need to avoid, so you'll actually want them to throw you at a very precise angle that prevents you from collecting coins. It's really annoying, really scary, but if you're lucky, it's possible as well. Pianta 6 will ask you to clean those villagers stuck in the lava paint, and there won't be a single coin on your way, so meh. This means Pianta 7 is up, and once again, it is a simple chase scene against Shadow Mario. Spray him with water, the shine will be yours, and Pianta Village will be complete! Uh-oh, looks like Shadow Mario has flooded Delfino Plaza, which means it's now time to chase him inside of this big scary volcano with a scary name that I can't say out loud anymore, or else YouTube will demonetize this video. Oopsie, anyways. For the sake of this video, we'll call it Potato Mountain. Well, we're in luck, because Potato Mountain doesn't contain any annoying coins on the way. There are none on those platforms, and the boat part allows you to easily dodge any blue coins on the way. All that is left is to make our way up these clouds and defeat Bowser in his bath. There are zero coins during the fight, so just grab the rocket nozzle, ground pound those things, and you will beat the game. And there we go! Bowser is defeated, Delfino Isle is safe, and so is Princess Peach, and Flood is dead! Nah, I'm kidding, Flood is not dead, okay? Toads repaired it. So, is it possible to beat Super Mario Sunshine without touching a single coin? Well, yes! Yes, it is! We even managed to beat it without touching a single blue coin, so that's pretty cool. If you actually watch out where you use Flood's water spraying mechanics, and if you just move around the coins, well, this quest is not very difficult. Thanks a lot for watching this video! I hope you enjoyed it! If you did, please give this video a like, subscribe, but mostly, can you hit the bell to be part of the notification gang? It would mean the world to me. In the meantime, if you want to see more epic challenges, well, make sure to tap the cards on screen right now, as I have done plenty more for you. Alright, my dudes, I'll see you in the next one.